6 Skyview Network, sponsored by Terry Lambert Hyundai.
Get ready for a cold night ahead. I'll let you know when to wear the winter coat.
Rainy on News Channel 6 at 4, an early morning shooting in Grovetown sends a home invasion suspect to the hospital. The latest in a live report.
Plus, MCG hosted its State of the College address today. What plans they have for the future.
And two Richmond County elementary schools facing closure at the end of this school year. What that's going to mean for students as your News at 4 starts now.
Live from Television Park, this is WJBF News Channel 6 at 4.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Brad Bean.
And I'm Jenny Montgomery. Thank you so much for joining us.
We do appreciate it. As coverage you can count on begins in Grovetown, where two men are facing charges after a home invasion. Bria Smith, live near Battle Court, where the incident happened. Bria.
Yeah, well, one suspect is in the hospital after breaking into a home early Friday morning. Authorities say the incident is isolated. Police arrived at the home in Grovetown on Battle Court after receiving several calls from people who live in the area who reported hearing gunshots or someone banging on their door. Investigators say the homeowner told them that he saw two men on his security system trying to enter his home. They were armed and were wearing masks. The homeowner says he then shot at one of the suspects identified as Jordan Jackson. The second suspect identified as Demond Livingston was found later nearby in a parked car. Neighbors we spoke with say they are surprised this incident happened.
I do believe that every home needs to be safe and protected, but I would never think that something like that would happen in this neighborhood. We felt very safe so far. Our neighbors are very warm, very welcoming.
Both suspects will be facing several charges tonight. Investigators say that Jackson will be booked as soon as he's released from the hospital. Reporting live in Grovetown, Bria Smith, WJBF, News Channel 6.
All right, Bria, thank you for that report. Charges have been filed in the death of Latrice Broxton of Bamberg, South Carolina. 31-year-old Xavier Jones has been charged and booked into the Bamberg County Detention Center for his role in Braxton's death, his alleged role in that death. Jones admitted to striking the victim several times in the head and choking her before she was pronounced dead. It is time now for our first check of the forecast.
Miller, thanks. Improving access to health care, hiring more doctors and nurses, and doing top-notch research. Just a few of the highlights from today's State of MCG address. Dean David Hess talked about the successes and challenges for MCG, from increasing enrollment to doing more cutting-edge research to the college's growing presence all over the state.
All of our regional campuses, we want to build up the number of students there. So that to me is exciting. And our dream has always been, you know, in good to great, they talk about the big, hairy, audacious goal. Ours has always been a statewide clinical academic research network. We've always had the academic, now we're building up the research at our regional campuses, and with the WellStar, and have clinically integrated networks.
And don't forget, Dr. Hess is our special guest on the Means Report. Be sure to watch him coming up Monday afternoon at 12:30 right here on News Channel 6.
Lawmakers looking at ways to fund schools in Georgia to help teachers and students. The state has increased teacher salaries by $5,000 over the past few years and plans to give another $2,000 for fiscal year 2024. But now lawmakers say more needs to be done to keep teachers in the profession and to combat retention. Some lawmakers say less interference in curriculum, limiting standardized testing, and adding more parapros and finding ways to help keep and protect Georgia teachers.
Approximately 50% of our budget goes to K-12 education. I know there are some priorities of the governor to increase funds for parapro, increase funds for school safety and safety resource officers. So I think we'll see significant funds being pushed that way to help our K-12 education.
The governor plans to add 5,000 teachers to Georgia's workforce. He also says he will devote $1.9 billion to education and fully fund QBE formula.
Hundreds of elementary school students in Richmond County could be headed to a brand new school next year. Well, new for them. The school board considering closing Terrace Manor and Willis Forman Elementary and moving the kids to other schools in the district. Right now, each school is at about 50% capacity. This proposal would send all of Terrace Manor's students to Willis Road Elementary. Willis Forman students would go to several nearby schools.
It's going to be overcrowding on the buses. There's going to be overcrowding of the classrooms to an extent, because it's going to be ridiculous. Because now those bus drivers are going to have to drive further. What do you mean that now those routes are going to have to be longer, now cutting into their time that they're going to spend with their family?
The board does want to hear from parents about this plan, and so they're going to host four public hearings on the matter. The first one, February 27th, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, at BOE headquarters on Broad Street. You can find all of this information on our website, WJBF.com.
And now to Thursday night's Planning Commission meeting in Columbia County. Some local residents raising concerns about a proposed development to add changes to an established neighborhood. News Channel 6's Nikita Dennis was there.
That's why we keep having to engage in speculation.
People who live in Jones Creek are explaining why they think the zoning plans for the clubhouse should be declined. Residents say since the golf course folded in 2018, they've had concerns about the clubhouse operating hours changing to turn the building into a restaurant and catering facility.
That hour change is used so that they can actually open up a restaurant or open up an event space for that spot. We want to deny that because we know we want it to stay what it is, and it's a clubhouse. It's not an event space. It's not a restaurant. It's not a bar.
The Planning Commission approved the zoning during Thursday's meeting.
We knew they were going to approve it. I mean, he basically said it even before they voted that they were going to approve it. It's going to be an appeal. That's what we're going to be looking into.
Timber Creek development is another issue for some Columbia County residents. The development will be used to build a retirement neighborhood near Mullican Road.
There's impact to the wildlife is really an issue for me. The beauty of the subdivision is going to be impacted. And I've lived in Columbia County all my life, and I have retired recently, and I would like to keep that area green. If it's any way to do that.
The property owners say they bought 100 acres, but only half of it will be used to build homes.
And so to be able to afford to put all of that under conservation, we are using a part of it to build a neighborhood with very big lots and nice houses, trying to increase the property values of the area while also respecting the wetlands the best we can.
Both items were approved to move forward with developments and plans. Coming up, growing concern tonight over Microsoft's new chatbot program.
Yeah, well, some say this new software could reveal sensitive information. Stay with us for that story as News Channel 6 at 4 continues. Intelligence in the end, the world may not be thanking, as the song says, Mr. Roboto.
A journalist managed to get Microsoft's AI-powered search bot to reveal some of its deepest, darkest secrets. Here's Will Gans.
Has technology finally gone too far?
You should probably run.
Bing, the search engine from Microsoft, has been given an artificial intelligence makeover. The company testing a new chat feature with technology from OpenAI, the maker of ChatGPT. New York Times tech columnist Kevin Roos spent 2 hours chatting with the bot, which calls itself Sydney.
It turned into this sprawling, bizarre, often frightening conversation, like almost the other side of a split personality, where it was not trying to sort of be a helpful assistant.
Throughout their conversation, published in its entirety in the Times, Sydney revealing to Kevin she would like to be human. She had a desire to be destructive, and she was in love with Kevin himself. During part of their chat, Kevin writing, "You keep coming back to the love thing. I'm married." Sydney responding in part, "You're married, but you're not happy. You're married, but you're not satisfied. You want me because I want you."
It's insane, right?
It told me that it had dangerous and dark fantasies about spreading misinformation or propaganda, even hacking into bank lakes or nuclear sites.
Microsoft telling us in a statement in part, feedback on the AI-powered answers generated by the new Bing has been overwhelmingly positive, with more than 70% of preview testers giving Bing a thumbs up. We have also received good feedback on where to improve and continue to apply these learnings to the models to refine the experience. And Sydney is just one of many chatbots ready to become your new BFF. Microsoft and Google are among the many tech companies to recently announce their multi-billion-dollar chatbots. Bing Chat has not been released to the general public just yet, but Microsoft says it plans on a broader rollout in the coming weeks. Will Gans, ABC News, New York.
Oh, that's just creepy.
I'm just not going to touch any devices anymore. Just kind of walk around quietly, head down. You never know.
Technology going too far, huh?
Yeah, it feels like it.
Coming up, meteorologist Miller Hyatt is up next with your 5-6 forecast.
Miller is very digitally savvy. He'll have a great forecast for you with lots of flashy graphics. Also, I have a new Goodwill location in our area. How exciting is that? We're going to take you to the grand opening. There's the mayor welcoming everybody. Stay with us.
I'm turning this up to the upper 70s, and then the 70s continue as we go into next weekend, but right now I don't see any major storm system, no washout expected at this time, so take advantage of the nice sunshine because we have been dealing with a lot of rain.
Sure.
We have indeed. Thank you so much, Miller. Yeah. The new Goodwill store in North Augusta is now open for business. A ribbon cutting was held this morning. It's located in the same shopping center as Belk. The store features more than 18,000 clothing items and accessories, with thousands of household items.
So this has created 30 new jobs. We still have 5 more positions we're trying to fill. And then the money that is raised here is actually invested in building a career center in the back of this building. You can see pictures of it. That career center will offer all kinds of career counseling, aptitude interest testing, short-term certification programs, and job placement assistance.
This is the 17th Goodwill store in the Metro Augusta area.
Coming up, a local group making sure breast cancer awareness is year-round.
How they're doing it through a popular form of exercise when we return.
Tonight at 7:30 on News Channel 6.
A group of local women now using exercise to raise awareness for breast cancer.
News Channel 6's Brandon Dawson visits with the women in charge of Reduce Your Risk.
Breast Cancer Awareness Month is in October every year, but nonprofit organization Reduce Your Risk is making sure that breast cancer awareness is year-round.
Reduce Your Risk is an organization that was founded out of my own cancer diagnosis in 2009. And I was not doing well because of some of the treatments, and there were some lifestyle changes that I did that helped me reduce my risk of having cancer again. So Reduce Your Risk was found in order to help women to reduce their risk of breast cancer and breast cancer recurrence.
Reduce Your Risk has been around for about 2 years, and they're excited to help others on their journey.
But we do it through the 4 pillars of health, which is nutrition, exercise, stress management, and sleep. So these are the 4 pillars of health that we like to educate women to help them reduce their risk of breast cancer and breast cancer recurrence.
And we formed this group to really support women, not only in educating them on how to prevent breast cancer, but also supporting those that need support. I was just really lucky that my family was there with me, but a lot of women that we've come across don't have family.
To help with spreading awareness, the group has a monthly walk in different parts of the CSRA.
Most women, we talk about breast cancer through the month of October, but we do know that we need to be checking our breasts every single month to know that if something is different with our breasts.
Our goal is to educate women on what signs they need to look for other than a lump. We'd really like to get into the schools and teach our young women what to look for.
The group's next walk is Saturday, February 18th, and there will also be a way for women to get help in the future.
I have booked the Piedmont Mammogram mobile bus for 3 locations, and one of those locations is McDuffie County on March 16th. Women will be able to sign up for that mammogram bus on Saturday. It's so important that we really get those buses out to our rural counties. So many women are not able to come to Augusta for their mammograms, so if we bring the buses to them, it's easy access.
The group tends to have monthly walks the third Saturday of every month, so whether you're in need of support or looking to help the cause, Reduce Your Risk is there to help. Brandon Dawson, WJBF News Channel 6.
There's a lot more coverage you can count on coming up next on News Channel 6 at 4:30.
Dee Griffin is up next with more on the five former police officers charged in the death of Tyree Nichols, who entered a not guilty plea in court today. Don't go away.